Hi Gemini, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and today we'll be doing your love read. Let's see what's happening between you guys, Gemini. How are you doing, how your person is doing, and what action we can expect now in this connection. And these are general collective readings, Gemini. Will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you, leave the rest. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Gemini and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Gems, let's begin. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. And if you're new here, Gemini, we welcome you as well. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. So Gems, I'm setting down two sets of cards here. One side is for you, one side is for your person. And in the center, I'll have your mutual energies, and your action cards and your dialogue cards. All right. So Gemini, if for the duration of this reading, I'll be mentioning this side is person A, this side is person B. So you'll know, right, exactly which side you resonate best with. For me, this is person A and this is person B. And here are your action cards. Okay, so bottom of my deck, the overall energy is the Ace of Swords. A conversation or some truth or some clarity which needs to come to this connection. Maybe there's already been some communication, some direct communication, which I think has made person A a little upset and angry. Person A has kind of lost trust almost, because maybe it was a matter of commitment, maybe they wanted commitment from person B, and whatever this conversation has happened or is going to happen, I don't know, it's going to kind of piss off person A big time. Whereas person B is concerned, they've retreated, they've gone into hermit mode, they've put a board outside their door saying do not disturb. This person has totally gone in. With Four of Swords is like, you know, spending time with yourself, and so is Hermit. They don't want to face, I think, this conversation, or they are thinking about it, or they don't want to be part of any decision making. Something has happened here, Gemini, where two people are on very different pages here. What I'm going to do, Gems, is first I'm going to start with some dialogue message cards. Let's see if you guys wanted to say something to each other, what that would be. Gemini and their person. Gemini and their person. Spirit, if they could say something to each other. Okay. I'm going to take a few more from here, Gems. Gemini and their person. Okay, Gems, let's begin our reading. I intuitively know that we will unite in divine timing. So maybe there's a separation right now, but one person feels, no, this was meant to be. Sometimes, because I know we will be together, I take you for granted. See, again, that feeling that I know we meant for each other, I know we're going to be together. I keep looking up at the stars, hoping you're looking at them at the same time that I do. Do you really believe I'm the one for you? I'm happy for you. I bury you with lies. I'm scared to tell you the truth. I feel so stupid for choosing lust over love. I would be honored to give you children. Okay, Gems, these are some of your messages. If they resonate with your storyline, let's start clarifying these cards. But before that, I'm going to take an angel blessing card, see how my angels are going to bless this reading with a blessing, guidance, advice, or a message. Blessings of abundance for you, Gemini. I don't know what's happening in your love life, but overall, my angels are blessing you with a lot of abundance in your life. So that's your blessing for this week. Okay, so I'm going to put this here. And now let's start clarifying your cards. So for person A, Spirit, why do they have the Queen of Swords in reverse with the Hierophant? Queen of Swords. Queen of Swords is very upset. Person A is very, very upset because I think they really wanted their person to show up as the person who would take charge, who would be their perfect spouse, who, you know, would be there for them forever. But I think somebody's hopes got dashed here. Maybe some communication happened, or maybe that communication that they were waiting for didn't happen. Something happened here where person A kind of is losing hope, because this commitment which they've been maybe wishing and hoping for seems like a lost cause, because I don't think person B really took the action that they expected them to. And now person A is feeling a bit upset and angry. What happened in the recent past, Spirit, for person A to be feeling this way? King of Wands in reverse with the Four of Pentacles. So it seems person A now, I think, perceives that person B was a bit selfish, was a bit self-centered, maybe not ending things with them, but still holding back from actually kind of offering them this brand new beginning. Right, so they feel somebody, they feel my partner, this is person A feeling, my partner was very, very selfish. They kind of leave me in the loop, never really, offering me maybe love, but it really doesn't amount to anything. It's like, yes, I do care for you and I'm your friend and we can be together forever and I'll keep meeting up, but hey, let's not, talk about commitment. Even though person A, I think, has been waiting and waiting and waiting and holding on very strong to the, thought that one day this commitment will come. But maybe in the recent past they realized that their person was unwilling or being very self-centered or holding back from this commitment. And yes, there could have had been a little fight here as well, Gemini. Maybe some communication did take place where there were some maybe harsh words spoken, or some immature behavior. It's come to a place where, or maybe their partner said that, I'm not ready for the responsibility of a long-term commitment. So that's the reason I think person A is now feeling quite disappointed, angry, upset, because they feel their hopes and dreams are not coming true at the moment. So how does person A now see person B, or how do they see the connection, Spirit? Three of Pentacles and the Nine of Cups. This was sideways. I'm going to do this again. Spirit, Three of Pentacles and the Nine of Cups. How does person A see this connection now, or person B? They really wish to make things work between the two of you, but at the moment they feel their partner is really not putting in any investment, and that's kind of creating a bit of bad feelings between the two of you. They feel my person has made a decision, but person A does really want to work on things. They want things to work out. Heart of hearts, I think, for person A, person B really works. They make them really happy and they want this happy outcome, even though right now they don't see it. And because they feel the person is kind of closed off or not making a decision, not choosing. As devastated, I think, as person A is feeling right now because of the stagnancy, they're hoping maybe that this is just a pause. And one day my wishes and dreams will come true. Yes, that is the anger is because of the stagnancy. The Queen of Swords is out again with the Page of Pentacles and the Knight of Pentacles. This is a lot of halted energy. And that is what is really pissing off this Queen of Swords, to say, hey, you make me happy. I want to work things out. But I don't see any investment coming from your end. Okay, so what action person A is going to take now? I'll open later, Gems. Let me go on to person B's side and see how they're doing. Person B is in the Four of Swords and the Hermit energy. Why is that, Spirit? Absolutely correct. They are showing up as the King of Wands in reverse, and they are maybe thinking now, and they're in Hermit mode. They're thinking about all the illusions that were created in this connection. Maybe they are realizing that they are the ones, they are the reason why, you know, this tower has fallen, why there is this unrest. So I think person B is heavily thinking about maybe their own behavior, trying to find out what to do now. Hermit spirit? Yes, this person is feeling quite low. They're feeling quite depressed at the moment. They're feeling quite sad at the moment. Maybe because either they left somebody out in the cold, or maybe now they are feeling left out in the cold. But this person is totally isolated. They're not with anyone else either, Gems. But they feel that whatever choice or whatever decision they've made was probably not the best one. They feel they're kind of looking into their own selfish behavior, I think. One more. Even though I think person B really likes person A, they do see them as very kind and nurturing and loving, and all that is there. But I don't know, this person has made some kind of a decision not to go back, to commit. And that actually saddens them as well, because maybe you guys had a close-knit connection, maybe you guys were best friends. I don't know. Because in the recent past cards also, Gemini, I have the Six of Cups. This is like two people who like each other, people who have a good bond with each other, people who have maybe been friends for a long time, a kind of a soulmate connection. But then we have the Judgment card in reverse. Yes, I think somebody made a decision, even though the bond was felt, the bond was pure, it was good. Somebody made a decision here not to give it a second chance, maybe. And now they're feeling, oh my God, I've lost, you know, my person, because now I can no longer have anything solid with them. Maybe, I'd see, this could be a friends with benefits kind of a connection. Now they feel that now that I made a decision not to offer commitment, I may lose, you know, the passion as well, or I may lose this connection. It's actually making person B feel quite sad. Judgment in reverse, spirit? Judgment in reverse. Yeah, certain secrets have come out, maybe regarding a third party, or maybe about how person B is not interested in maybe a future or something like that. And they're kind of thinking about their own behavior. How does person B now view this connection, spirit? Or how do they view person A? Six of Pentacles. They do see person A in a good light. They do wish that, you know, even if I don't, this is what they're telling me, even if, you know, there is no future of a long-term potential or a long-time commitment, I would like to return back to person A. I don't want them to keep barriers up. I don't want to keep barriers up and have this defensive kind of a, you know, stance between the two of us, because we were happy together. We had a very good balanced relationship. So, which is unfair, because per person, maybe B was happy with the way things were, like we are friends and I don't have to commit. But maybe person A got fed up of that and they asked a question, and the answer they got was not the one they wanted to hear. What's this moon card, spirit? What's this moon card? Person B also feels that feeling a little emotional at the moment. Yes, they're feeling a bit emotional, maybe because they may have said something which was very harsh. Maybe they were unemotional or rude to person A. Then they may have told person A that, hey, this is my choice, this is my decision. And they're kind of feeling, you know, I've lost this partnership now. I've lost this equal give and take. Now things will be different. I've lost a good partner. The person B is also quite fearful of this change that's happening. Let's see, person A, will you take any action now towards person B? Because person A still hopes, I did see. They do hope that one day, you know, things can change and I'll have my Nine of Cups again. Yeah, see here, Ace of Pentacles. So why is Ace of Pentacles action that person A can take? Ace of Pentacles. One more. I think person A may drop their defenses because they do want this, you know, start of this connection once again. Somebody is not happy at all. They're not happy of this, with the stagnancy which has hit this connection. They're not happy at all. They feel like they lost. They feel like a loser right now because they feel, you know, this was a very strong connection. They do want to let down their guard now. I don't know whether they will reach out, be the first one to reach out. They may be, but they're at least hoping for this communication to begin again. So will person A be the first to connect, spirit? Will they take action towards person B? Yes. This is Sagittarius energy, Knight of Wands. Person A still has a lot of passion, lot of drive. This is not a masculine feminine card, Gemini. This is somebody who has a lot of passion, who wants to take action now, right? So person A may be the first one who will say, hey, can we begin again? Or, you know, I'm not happy that we guys are not talking, or this connection has come to a stagnancy. So person A, this is the connection they would like to take. Some of you may not, but this is in the cards. So person B, now I don't know, Gemini, which side you're on. You could be on person A's side, you could be on the other side, right? So person B, will you take any action now? Hanged Man. Why is Hanged Man? They are trying to delay it for some reason. They don't want to. They're kind of stuck right now. They feel they've created too much of rift. Yes, there's too much of conflict. There's too much of, you know, unrest which has been created. I think person B is taking their time. I think they're trying to see things from all different angles, see things from different perspectives. And yes, there could be some kind of a delay going on here. They're wondering whether they should drop this altogether or... They don't want to be in a place where they are worried all the time, or there's fear or anger or upset. Right now they feel there's too much of that. There's too much conflict between the two of you. Maybe if you guys have had a fight or something, this person is kind of taking their time. They are in hangman's position. They are in hermit mode right now. They're taking some time out to reflect. Okay, so I don't know what's going on here. You would know. So that's all I have for you. Till next time then, Gemini. Take care. Love and light. Namaste.